been too challenged. Lena Kamas with two goals, giving Sydney FC the advantage. I see that there might be an early substitution now on the halfway mark. We've got two Western Sydney Wanderers players set to come on. So Heather Garrick, it looks like it's going to be a debut for Rachel Lowe and Georgia Plessis.
And it's great to see two young Matildas that have just gone away to China last week come on off the bench, especially Rachel Lowe and Georgia Plessis. Rachel Lowe, she's only a youngster. Debut for her, it's great to see. She's a midfielder, she'll be able to control the midfield. She's extremely athletic, she'll get up and down and combine very well in the midfield. That's exactly what they need.
Well, they certainly need a spark of some kind. Western Sydney Wanderers side has got quite a lot of football experience at the moment. Be interesting to see where these changes are going to be made.
And for Georgia Plessis as well, put her on. If she's on her game, she has got an absolutely quality left foot. Can score goals from anywhere.
Well, that's the American Alexis Arlett who makes way for Rachel Lowe in the back line, and Eliza Amendolia for Georgia Plessis. Alexis Arlett joined the Wanderers from FC Kansas City this season, one of four Americans in this Wanderers side. Led by the ball passer there, Katie Stengel. Washington Spirit also had a stint with Bayern Munich. Now fellow American Paige Nielsen to Joey Burgess. This thing from Kendall Fletcher.
Interesting to see if it was a tactical move there from Byrne, putting Georgia Plessis at left back. She's extremely quick, very attacking minded, can get up and down, similar to Ellie Carpenter, so maybe that's the game plan come the second half.
It's Carpenter with the throw, goes over the head of Stengel. Alana Kennedy switches, finds Yeoman Dale on the opposite flank. What do you think Rich Byrne thought wasn't working for them, Heather?
I think the front third. I think their last ball and delivery, they're not able to play at a quick tempo and not able to move Sydney FC. And that allowed the last pass not getting in behind and Sydney FC transitioning very quickly and getting goal scoring opportunities. So it's going to be hard for West Sydney to get back in the game.
Nelson set in a ball that rebounded off Stengel and now it's away with Sydney FC. Maya Simon sends it well over the top to Remy Simpson, who's equal to the challenge. Lena Kamas lurking at the top of the box. Tobin. Dale is dispossessed on the opposite flank. It's Nielsen supplies Burgess. And the tack is on now for the Western Sydney Wanderers. Ellie Carpenter looking for red and black shirts inside the area. Still with Carpenter, still with Ellie Carpenter, looking to cut back. And it's rolled over the line.
That was a really good run by Carpenter, but again, isolated in the wide areas. She had no one to combine with her, no one just to lay the ball off and get the ball back in behind Sydney FC. She's tapping left, right foot, and just away from Hannah Bacon. That would have been a good byline cross from Ellie. So we need to see more of that for Sydney FC to be effective. Likewise on the opposite side with Georgia Plessis.
Well, Sydney FC is sitting pretty at the moment here at Allianz Stadium in Sydney. The sun is shining and the sky is certainly blue, both in the sky and on the pitch. Well, crossed in for the Western Sydney Wanderers. Could be on here, but it's grasped in by Sham Karmas and potentially the most threatening that Western Sydney have looked in quite some minutes. Second half just underway here. If you're joining us now, Sydney FC two goals up through the boot of Lena Kamas. Kamas with the double and scored two in the last Sydney derby. So clearly an opposition that she enjoys playing, as would most Sky Blues. This is a very special fixture. part of a doubleheader with the Men's Hyundai A-League. Sydney FC hosting Perth Glory, and the men's team absolutely flying. For the women's team, this would be a first 3 points on the board should the status quo remain. Ralston with a neat ball looking for Bolger. Just out of reach.
Had Bolger controlled that well and taken a better touch, she would have been in front of Carpenter and one-on-one with the goalkeeper. Carpenter caught on the wrong side of Bolger.
Carpenter's throw comes off the head of Fletcher. It's turned over to Sydney FC in the form of Hannah Bacon. Simon ducks under that. Karmas' boot provides for Tobin, still there. And it's on again for Lena Karmas. Still with Lena Karmas. Parried away. Bolger. Sydney FC looking very dangerous indeed. And there's always so many bodies in the box willing to turn provider.
And again, that come from Lena Karmas. She's not the quickest of players, but the way she backs in, uses her body and is able to turn players is unbelievable. And she would have loved to get a hat-trick at the Sydney Derby. And no doubt she'll be looking for one.
The Sky Blues somewhat stung by that first-round loss. Heather Garrick beaten by Brisbane Roar up in Brisbane. So a slowish start for them. It's better, though, than their Season 8 start. We take a look again at that opportunity. It was a neat backheel there to put the ball at the feet of Lena Karmas.
Great little backheel and a great tackle there by Arlett. Just the shot was at the nice height of Fajara Wyman.
Well, the start to the season, of course, not quite as dire as Season 8. Heather Garrick, do you recall the 6-0 drubbing by Melbourne City, which opened Sydney's season last time round?
Exactly. You'd say it's a better start to the season for Sydney FC and a better start after being up 2-0 in the Sydney Derby as well so far. But again, the Wanderers are still in this game. Their possession is quite good. They're trying to build up. They just can't get that last pass, that final pass.
They're having trouble with that, and Katie Stengel not getting too much support. She leads the line for the Wanderers.
And the substitution made, Rachel Lowe isn't usually a wide player or a forward. Usually she's a midfielder.
Fletcher bundled over by Teresa Pallas, who goes into the referee's notebook. First card of this game.
And it was a fairly hard challenge, and Kendall Fletcher doesn't normally go down, but this is in shooting range for her. She's got great quality on set plays. Probably a smart, experienced foul by Pallas.
Here's Fletcher, who stands ready to deliver the free kick. Bettinas at the top of the box. Cluster of red and black shirts lurking in wait. Be a perfect time for Western Sydney Wanderers to open their scoring. Oh, Fletcher delivers harmlessly over the top of everyone.
Fletcher would be disappointed with that delivery. She just clipped it in, right height for the goalkeeper.
Well, Karmas thought she was on challenging for a third goal less, or the flag go up on the opposite side.
Karmas is the heart and soul of this team. You can just see how much she loves it, how much she wants it, how much she wants to play for Sydney FC. She's so passionate. She gets the girls going. She's a fantastic leader out there. And I'll tell you what, playing alongside her, you want to win.
Oh, good, the Wanderers snatch one back here. Tobin definitely dispossesses. Sends the ball up with Bolger now. Karmas behind her. She struggles to control, but it's Kai Simon that runs away. The ball. Tobin not able to pick up, and it's Rachel Lowe. All the Wanderers. Now Nielsen. Stengel rushing to get in position. Ellie Carpenter looking up. Still with Ellie Carpenter. It's nudged away by Bacon. Carpenter looks to get through. Simon comes in to challenge. Joey Burgess winds up. Still with Burgess. Rushes over to keep it in. Back to Carpenter. Oh, Fletcher turns. Neat footwork. All the way over to Rachel Lowe on the far side. Baxter manages to keep the ball in. A tumble there. Georgia Plessis. And the Wanderers are trying and having trouble just executing a final killer blow. Will Joey Burgess be able to do it? Burgess trickles through for Stengel. Stengel can't find a clear shot. Kendall Fletcher now. Wanderers trying everything, but that Sydney FC defence so far impenetrable. Ellie Carpenter almost loses possession and beaten to the ball by Bacon. Carpenter the fastest up. The flag is temporarily up still with Ellie Carpenter. Safely to the boot of Alana Kennedy. And Western Sydney Wanderers just unable to find a chink in that sky blue wall.
The thing that was promising about the Wanderers just there, they were patient in the build-up. It went from one side to the other and really, really patient. They just need that final pass, though. That's the one thing that's letting them down.
Well, how about that for a final pass? Bolger puts it in for Karmas. Almost had it through four. Perhaps Remy Simpson, who was flying into the box. Certainly Western Sydney Wanderers that have had the greater number of balls into the area, which haven't been able to convert them to goals as yet.
It could be something to do with the Sydney FC defence, but also it's very much a transition-based game at the moment.
That's a better ball, though, for Katie Stengel. Unfortunately, unable to run that one down. There's been a lot of action for the American internationals. Of course, Alexis Arlette has finished her shift for the day. But, Paige Nielsen, Kendall Fletcher, Katie Stengel still on the park. Interestingly, no internationals in sky blue shirts.
Yeah, look, you can see positives and negatives in both of that, but I think it's a real positive. It's fantastic to see Caitlin Ford as a marquee player. She's world class.
How about that world class ball from Alana Kennedy? She really can pick out her players on the other side. Jada Wyman saw that one all the way in, and we can tell you that Dan Barrett looks set to make his first change, and Olivia Price is being readied on the sideline. Bacon asking a little bit too much of Kai Simon. Caitlin Cooper sends it over the whitewash. It'll be a Sydney throw as that change is made. It's Hannah Bacon, who wasn't expecting to start, now makes way for Olivia Price.
And Dan Barrett is going to take, or put Nat Tobin probably back into the left back area and push Price there, who's very calm on the ball, but is a little bit early for that change. Bacon wasn't doing too bad at left back. Some good tackles she made. So a good game by her, especially at late notice, coming into the side.
So you think he's gone a little bit too early?
Yeah, look, you don't know the game. Wanderers have certainly could have got in a couple of times.
Sydney FC that's seen the joy in front of goal. Two goals up here and knocking on the door for a third. Now Kennedy. Oh, it's neat footwork from Alana Kennedy. Finds Tobin on the near side. Now Remy Simpson. Matilda scored a hatful over in China. Too much trickery there for Kai Simon. Remy Simpson, what a month she's had.
She certainly has, and she's on top of the world. And such a lovely kid. Great parents as well, and been brought up in a really humble family, and she deserves everything she's gotten so far.
What she got was 10 goals in two games for the young Matildas. Look at that ball from Simon to the feet of Karmas. Well, Lena Karmas turns provider, almost had Simpson in on goal, and maybe a little bit unselfish from Lena Karmas.
Yeah, you don't see that very often. Karmas passing the ball in the box. I'm sure she would have gone for that hat-trick, but Remy was just on the other side of the defender, and she probably could have gotten in front of her a little bit better and just clipped the back of her heel. That would have been an even better month for her to score 2 days after her birthday.
2 days after birthday, on debut in the W League, after putting 10 goals away for the junior national team.
She wasn't even on the radar for the Young Matildas 4 weeks ago.
So where's she come from? How's this overnight discovery happened?
She scored a bag full of goals in the New South Wales Premier League, went away to NTC, didn't get too much time, didn't fit into the system. But yeah, then got Player of the Year and was poached by the assistant coach for the Young Matildas.
Plays now with the Western Sydney Wanderers. Lily Carpenter, another youngster, 16 years old, flying down the flank. Sends it centrally, headed away by Liz Ralston. Now with Kendall Fletcher. Fletcher looks up, puts it in the air. It's nodded away again by Sydney FC. On that occasion, Nat Tobin still on the attack. Western Sydney Wanderers, and now Teresa Palaz puts an end to their play.
I almost feel, Steph, that the Wanderers are getting the build-up, trying to play the possession. Just that final pass, similar to the Canberra of yesterday. Just can't execute that final pass and are getting in the box, but just not getting players on the end of it.
Oh, Tobin shepherding the ball safely to her keeper. Let's go down the sideline, Amy Duggan.
Thank you, Steph, and joined by Richard Byrne, the coach of the Western Sydney Wanderers. Your first derby, how have you seen it so far?
Oh, look, we started off the second half quite well. We're together, we're pressing the way we want to press, for sure. We want to try and utilise the right more with Ellie going forward. We'll just see how it plans out.
You're two down at the moment. That's a big ask to get back from here. Where's the something special going to come from?
Like we said, look, we've set up a little bit different in the second half. We're wanting to play our game and wanting to move the ball around from right to left more. If we can utilise the space on the wings with our fullbacks, overlapping fullbacks, that will help us.
All right, well, good luck for the rest of the half.
Thank you very much indeed, Rich Byrne. It's always an interesting step to take when you get that promotion up to the W League.
Yeah, exactly. He's been different for the Wanderers, and the girls seem to like his style. That's a quality tackle by Cooper. Very experienced. Just stuck a shoulder in there. Welcome to the W League, Samson.
Yeah, indeed. Tried a bit of tit for tat, but the Wanderers captain a little bit too wise. Remy Simpson not getting any joy. And Jakowitz is going to just to hold play. She has a little word to Remy Simpson, perhaps saying, let's not get too excited here.
Interesting comment that Byrne made about the pressing. Stengel still going out solo in terms of pressing, and Lowe and Patinos aren't putting direct pressure on the ball. That's the reason why Sydney FC are getting out constantly like this. I don't see the pressure.
Tobin back to Kennedy. Sydney FC sitting very comfortably, very relaxed. As you would expect, being two goals to the good. A new turn from Bolger with Karmas. Nice work there. Lena Karmas back in front of goal. Two with Karmas. Back heel for Bolger. Bolger assesses her options. Still bobbling around inside the area and eventually cleared to safety. But Sydney FC just so threatening.
They certainly are. And it's a combination play in the front third. I love it. It's just a joy to watch the back heels and the step overs and the dummies. It's brilliant.
Very tricky on again now with Bolger. Thought she might have been fouled. Jakowitz doesn't blow the whistle, and now it's perhaps an opportunity for Western Sydney. Joey Burgess pass a bit loose. Nat Tobin gratefully accepts. Feels like it's one-way traffic, Sydney FC. Now Palaz. Good footwork from Teresa Palaz, just creating space back heel again for Kaya Simon. Simon unleashes plucks that in.
And Cooper made a run into the midfield there and got caught out, and it could have been a Sydney FC.
Oh, it is on for Sydney FC. It's been fumbled. Jada Wyman again. I think her heart rate's probably ratcheted up a notch.
And Simpson one-on-one with a goal. Goalkeeper, and it could have been a goal up for Remy. She choked in front of goal, unfortunately.
Oh, it could be on here now for Joey Burgess. Go from one of the youngest players to one of the most mature players. Joe Burgess found the back of the net last week, and quite satisfying to see her on the scoreboard again here. It's one game, one goal, of course, would change the whole complexion of this match.
It would. It put Sydney FC under quite a lot of pressure, and Sydney are cruising at the moment. They're just knocking the ball around. There's no pressure whatsoever playing out. They're happy to play back. They know it's hot out there. But there looks like there's no midfield whatsoever for the Wanderers.
Enjoying that. How about that ball through? Sydney FC could be on for a third goal here. Oh, and it is palmed away by Jada Wyman. That was a sensational save from the 17-year-old Western Sydney Wanderers goalkeeper.
And this save in particular is the reason why. It's a great overlapping run from Yeomandale. She'd be very disappointed not to score that. But this kid is going to be a future Matilda. Her shot-stopping skills, her footwork is unbelievable. She's kept the Wanderers in the game, for sure.
Well, delivered in for the Wanderers. Not controlled by Wyman, but the whistle's gone. Frustration taps as Kennedy prods it to the back of the net anyway.
And another great corner from Pelias. She hits a ball flat with a lot of pace on it. And Alana Kennedy in the back of Wyman. And I think that was a soft free kick. Goalkeepers these days seem to be very protected.
Well, it was ever thus. Here, another attack mounted down this right flank with Ellie Carpenter. She's been well dealt with, but yeah, she finds her option on the right. Back in for Ellie Carpenter, a race with Alana Kennedy. Way too much experience. A 21-year-old, but how about that? A youngster dispossessing her senior Matilda's teammate. One lobbed in, Paige Nielsen streaming into the box. Katie Stengel, rather. Oh, Karmas is set on a run again. Well, it's to and fro here, and pretty end-to-end football is... might be a, yes, it is a second card for this match. Perhaps a little bit too much enthusiasm, and she's taken it down from behind.
Yeah, and I think she sort of needed to. She needed to get a body in there. She was just trying to catch up the play, and she was on the wrong side of her, unfortunately. But it's good to see her trying to track back and get the ball back from losing it further up the field.
Well, Remy Simpson on the stat sheet, probably not the one she wanted just yet, but plenty of time left in this match. Can the Wanderers pull a goal back here? Trying ever so hard. Nearly 70 minutes in this match and they haven't found any joy at all. Sham Karmas has been up to the challenge. The Sydney FC wall has been impenetrable. Goes in and well over again, and those free kicks just not have not been the quality that you're either hoping or wanting.
Yeah, not the quality you'd expect, not at all, especially with the amount of set plays and free kicks and corners that the Wanderers have occurred and had a chance to capitalise on.
Pressure placed on Kennedy by Katie Stengel, who's still a bit of a lone wolf. Joey Burgess a little bit further forward. Kendall Fletcher picks up a loose ball, says, thank you very much, we'll take that. Joey Burgess. It was easily dealt with by Alana Kennedy. Cuts off the Wanderers' attack again, and Kai Simon releasing Remy Simpson. Still with Simpson. Now Tobin. Lena Karmas is asking for it.
And had she got it, Steph, she would have been one-on-one with the keeper.
She would have. Katie Stengel disappointed to see the flag go off. She felt she might just have been away too.
Stengel certainly has been a handful for Ralston and Kennedy, but Kennedy's cool and calm at the back. She's up there by herself. No one to play with at the moment. You can see the Wanderers dropping both their forwards in to create more in defence.
Sydney FC haven't been under too much pressure, you wouldn't say. They've been well contained at times by the Wanderers, and certainly the Wanderers have looked more organised in this outing than they have in seasons past. But the ability to really be that threat in front of goal. Karma stays on the ground at one end as the Wanderers run away in attack. Kendall Fletcher now. Nielsen back to Fletcher. Joe Burgess worked so very hard in the attack for the red and black. Stengel, close attention from Ralston and Yeoman Dale. Yeoman Dale wins out. You'd have to think in this sort of heat that Stengel must be getting a little bit tired.
Yeah, she must be, and she's just sitting central there, wanting the ball at her feet. You don't see too many runs in behind the Sydney FC defence. But again, if you want the ball at your feet, then you need players running off, like a Lena Karmas or a Kaya Simon for Sydney FC. They do that so very well.
Well, we've ticked over the 70-minute mark here at Sydney Football Stadium. It's been a joy to watch these players ply their trade in the ninth Sydney Derby as we see neat work between Kaya Simon and Nicola Bolger. Bolger has scored plenty of times in sky blue. I think she might add their third. She winds up it harmlessly over the crossbar. No effort required from Jada Wyman. And we're about to see another substitute. Here it is, Erica Halloway, who was player of the season for the Western Sydney Wanderers last year, giving Joey Burgess a break.
And a well-earned break from Joey Burgess. She worked really hard in defence. Didn't get the attacking balls that she probably wanted, but Erica Halloway, first game back, should be buzzing. She's been out from injury for many months now. Illawarra Stingrays player, and let's see what she's got to offer. She's very sharp, unpredictable. Great to see her back on the park.
Yeah, we hope you're enjoying this derby match wherever you're watching. Fox Sports and the ABC. Broadcast doubleheader. In fact, it's been double delight this weekend. Kaya Simon busy again centrally. This is her options, and Germandale was waiting, but it's gone over the line. Throw in Western Sydney. It is remembrance round this weekend in both the W League and the A League as we pay our respects and commemorate those who serve and have served for their country. It's 99 years ago, it's 98 years ago this year rather, that the guns fell silent on the Western Front. Centenary commemoration set to come in 2018. So we do have the only serving player in the W League here today, Gabe Mazzano, on the Sydney FC bench. So the first certified female army diver. And of course that means she's moved around rather a lot, so we've seen her have stints in Brisbane. She also had one with Jamie Harnwell's side in Perth and helped them to a grand final. And a move to Holsworthy Base means she's back in Sydney and picked up by Sydney FC. Good get. Well, tempo really gone out of this match for the moment. Really needs a Western Sydney goal, doesn't it, Heather?
It does, just to lift the tempo, and I think legs are starting to get tired. You just saw that from Ellie Carpenter, just miscontrolled the ball. I think the next 20 minutes or 17 minutes need to be ball back on the deck, go back to the basics, because at the moment Sydney FC are running the show. They're picking up the ball, Kaya's getting it in the midfield and running the show in that area. I think that's been a fantastic move, her playing in the midfield today. She's certainly been the backbone and the creative player that's created a lot of the goals.
Yep, it's the Kaya Simon that we know and love. We're used to watched for many years in the W League, as we have Teresa Palais. There's laterally for Ralston. Yeoman Dale waiting. She's been busy down the flanks today. Twists and turns, doubles back. She's got sky blue shirts waiting inside. Well, that was neat footwork. Has dropped for Remy Simpson. Still on for Sydney FC. Fairly tame shot away at the end of all that.
Fairly ambitious shot from Price there. She's not left-footed. She's slightly off balance. It would have been great to see Sampson turn her defender and have a go.
Well, look at this neat footwork.
Really neat football from Price. She's cut it back. And again, there's a few bodies behind and a cute little turn on the left-hand side. Slightly off balance from Price. Easy for Wyman.
Olivia Price with her 17th appearance. She's snatched a goal before, so she knows how to score in a sky blue shirt. Ball cleared gratefully to safety temporarily by the Wanderers. They're spending an awful lot of time down in their own half. Sydney FC look relaxed. They're keeping the pressure turned up.
Sydney FC are able to get out because Rachel Lowe is sitting really deep. And I'm not too sure if that's the game plan, but if the Wanderers want to get a result out of this game, they need to go for it.
Nice to Bolger. Can't be stolen away by Western Sydney Wanderers. Still with Bolger. So good with her feet. Let's go down to Amy Duggan.
Yeah.
So I don't think Amy's quite ready for us with Dan Barrett as Toven takes the throw in. Back to Kennedy. Let's try our luck, Amy Duggan.
Steph, with a very blue-tongued Dan Barrett, blue through and through today. Comfortable position
to be. Ralston puts it over for Lena Karmas. It could be on for the hat-trick. Lena Karmas, it flashes just wide. What an attempt by Karmas. That's extraordinary. She gets a cramp stretched out by a teammate. To Lena Karmas, her boots are on fire today.
Absolutely on fire. She could have scored four or five goals. A great take there. She's beat the defender and just put it around. A great little touch from Wyman. She'd be disappointed with that. But again, Karmas getting in the right areas. Very difficult player to mark.
Oh, Teresa Palais heads over to deliver the corner again for Sydney FC. Amy Duggan, hang tight. We'll be coming back to you in just a moment. In fact, let's come back to you now as a substitution is made.
Thank you, Steph. Dan, a comfortable position to be in. 2-0 up, almost three just there. Are you happy?
Yeah and no. I mean, the chances that we've created and haven't scored have been a bit of a problem, and it was last week against Brisbane Roar as well, so we can't make a habit of not putting the ball in the back of the net.
We're about to see a change here. Are you on the hunt for more goals, or are you just relaxing and trying a few things out?
Look, we want to control the game. I think that's one area we need to be better too. We need to be a little bit smarter in situations like this, being 2-0 up. Sometimes playing some risky balls that we don't need to play. We're in front, so but always looking for more goals, 100%.
Have to be cheeky and ask this question. You are the only team with no international imports yet. Is there any news on that?
On their way.
Is that a promise?
Yeah.
So watch this space.
Absolutely.
Good luck for the rest of the second half.
Thank you very much.
Yep, Dan Barrett always up for more goals. However, they won't come from the boot of Lena Karmas as she's substituted for Princess Sabini, another one who's returned from young Matilda's duty. She's long since stepped out of the shadow of her brother and been on the radar since she was about 12 or 13, Heather.
She certainly has. Another Westfield Sports High School girl. And just returning from injury after 6 or 7 weeks with an ankle injury. getting some time over in China. It was great to see. She's such an impact player, and it'd be great to see what she does. She's so powerful and athletic.
Look at the work from Erica Holloway down this near flank too. The ball did end up with Katie Stengel. Made tough work of it, but Holloway in some pretty heavy traffic. Come on again now for Sydney. Gratefully headed away on the far flank. Wanderers back in possession. Well, loose pass, ambitious, careless.
I think it was supposed to go in behind the defence. Georgia Plessis, not usually a left-back player. Normally she plays as a forward, but...
It went behind the defence.
It certainly did. Whipped behind the defence, I probably should have said.
Glass, not overjoyed with that pass.
You can see the tempo certainly going out of the game for the moment.
Lena Karmas doesn't care. She's had two goals, and we just saw her with some fans who've come down to say hello, ask for an autograph, and perhaps with plans one day to be the next Lena Karmas, highest goal scorer in a sky blue shirt. Very popular with the young fans, as is the W League increasingly. As Fletcher tries to release Holloway. Kennedy shepherds back to Sham Karmas. Katie Stengel lurking as ever. Not controlled by Cooper. By Simon. Again with Simon, so creative in the midfield today. Now Price. Gabini next to her. Bolger waiting. Kai Simon running through. Still with Kai Simon. Oh, neat work, Jonah Wyman, but... Simon usually hits them with a little bit more venom.
I've seen plenty of those shots go in the back of the net. Looks as though that she's stretching her calves, but in terms of play, on the wrong side, Ellie Carpenter in no man's land defensively. But Kaya Simon again making a charging run.
The work has been done by Jada Wyman. Sham Karmas barely called into action. Ball harmlessly goes into the side netting. Oh, different challenges next week for both these sides. Western Sydney Wanderers stay home and greet Adelaide United. Sydney FC will be on the road to Melbourne Victory, who look a much improved side this time round. 6-goal thriller last week with Adelaide United. We've got some real talent in the navy blue.
It's great to see Jeff Hopkins coaching there and wanting to use the young talent of Victoria.
Well, look at the talent of Princess Sabini, if she can keep control. Catered for by the Western Sydney Wanderers defence, but Sabini, an exciting young talent, and I think she was spotted by Alan Stajic some years ago and brought through to the Sydney FC youth. Sydney line up for yet another corner.
Yeah, like I was saying before, many of these girls and many W League players that play in Sydney that go to Westfield Sports High School are on the radar very quickly.
Bolger's ready, Sampson. Kennedy's there. And a sixth save required from Jada Wyman this half. It's 1-on-3 for Erica Holloway, looking for support. Arrives in the form of Stengel and Nielsen. Both waiting ready. Jakowicz has blown the whistle. What's she signalling, Heather?
There's an injured player in the corner. Looks as though it's...
Oh, wow, so there is. It was a long, long way away in the far corner.
Teresa Pelias, is it? It is. She's got cramps from taking the corner. A couple of players have gone down with cramps. Not easy on a hot day. Big field.
Indeed, players... Gratefully grasp a drink. We've seen that Toven stretching out. Kai Simon's been stretching the hamstrings. Lena Karmas just before she was replaced. Those of you watching from home, perhaps in an air-conditioned lounge room, it's somewhere around the 30-degree mark out on the pitch. There is a stiff breeze blowing around Allianz Stadium, but it's a warm one as well.
It is. It makes it hard. Two games into the season, and it's been very, very difficult to have a long pre-season. So this is where we struggle, or all the players struggle.
Well, Sydney FC 2 goals to the good, courtesy of the boot of Lena Karmas, and a moment to celebrate, Heather.
Certainly is, and she is a prolific goal scorer. And again, just getting a touch on that, half chances that she always scores. She's always in the right place at the right time. And credit to Lena. She's such a quality striker. Or she's playing midfield today.
Yeah, she put in a great shift, Lena Karmas. Taking a well-earned break, and it's a real collection of fans behind that Sydney FC bench, hoping to see more from their idols as Paige Nielsen wriggles free. Presents for Kendall Fletcher. Oh, it's a bit alarming for Sham Karma. She's only been called into action this one time, but palmed over the bar. I think she thought she might have had that.
Yeah, it looks like Sham Karmas was trying to catch that. She's struck the ball and got a very quality shot. Kendall Fletcher.
She has a bit more pace on that than we first thought, perhaps.
Exactly.
Wanderer's corner. It's whipped in. Fletcher did make contact. Unfortunately, not on target.
No, it wasn't. It just went over Kennedy's head as well. So it seems as though every Wanderer's corner goes straight to Kennedy. This one, a little bit different. A possible goal-scoring opportunity.
Well, the Wanderers have been trying so very hard here in this Sydney derby.
There's certainly positive signs. The build-up from the Wanderers has been great. It's just their strike force. It's just their two wide players up front that probably need to be joining in play a little bit more with Stengel.
This is to Nielsen. Stengel's running in. It's going to drop harmlessly in front of the goalkeeper. And it just seems that with every build-up, that last shot is never quite dangerous enough for the Western Sydney Wanderers. I think they will have elements of this match that they'll be satisfied with. Perhaps feel that even the first half effort could have got a little bit more out of it. The possession starts blown out somewhat in Sydney FC's favour.
They definitely had a good first half and controlled the game and probably could have scored a couple of goals, but at this moment I think they're just tiring, and in terms of putting pressure on the ball and putting Sydney FC under pressure, they're not doing that well enough.
Big screens here in the stadium have just flashed up with could be on for Remy Simpson here. It was a dangerous moment. We're still back with Simpson. She's managed to recover possession. It's there for Tobin. Princess Sabini. Bolger almost on the end of that, gratefully cleared. As I said, the big screens here have just shown 4,198 rather, here at Allianz Stadium for this Sydney derby, and that, I believe, Heather Garrick, is a regular season record broken in week one at the Brisbane Roar match, and now we have a new one, over 4,000 here to witness the talent we have in the Westfield W League.
What better way to make this derby quality than to have the attendance of the crowd as a record-breaking crowd. It's fantastic to see. Sydney derbies, Melbourne derbies are always exclusive, always entertaining to watch. It looks as though the Sky Blue are going to claim the rights today.
Yep, the home fans likely to head home the happiest. It's probably a hill a little bit too steep to climb with just those few minutes remaining. I suspect we'll see some time added on. There was Teresa Pallas down just recently, and we have had a few incidents with cramp throughout the second half, but give or take, it's very tough for Western Sydney now, but well, stranger things have happened in football. Plenty of space over on this near side. Can the Wanderers make use of it? It's a nice tug on the shirt there for Holloway. No whistle, back heel. Oh, she's been collected by Kaya Simon, still down on the turf. No whistle yet. Simon sportingly puts the ball out.
That was certainly unintentional. Kaya's just tried to get a body in the way.
Dylan Carpenter, I think, that's on the deck. Been caught in the face, perhaps?
Yeah, just must have clipped her on the way back, but she doesn't normally go down. She's a tough cookie. but it looks as though she got caught in the neck. So Simon too quick.
Well, it was my fault, Heather, for talking about how many minutes would be added on. We've just added a couple more and under two in regulation time. Lee Carpenter, normally a pretty tough customer, Heather?
She certainly is. You have to be a tough customer when you're training with the likes of Lisa Devanna and Claire Polkinghorne and players like that, especially in the Matilda squad, leading up to the Olympic Games. She certainly has to be very proud of herself to make that Olympic team, and she certainly won't go off.
First player born in the new millennium to make that Matilda's side, and still just 16 years of age. I think she's managed to get a learner's permit. I don't think she's had any time at all to actually have any driving lessons.
I don't think she's in the country long enough to get those hours up.
And she takes a moment to recover as time ticks away, less than a minute of regulation time. Sydney FC can perhaps mount another attack.
Imagine how potent Sydney FC is going to be if they're signing a couple of more internationals.
No, indeed. Well, here is a chance for Western Sydney, and angle all wrong. Paige Nielsen. Pretty decent first outing, though, for these... first outing for our broadcast match, of course. They played last week, but pretty decent from these American imports.
Yeah, they've done really well. You can see the structure, you can see the want, you can see their passion of wanting to try and get a goal back, and you just saw by that strike the desperation.
They are desperate, and they've got 3 minutes to make that desperation count. At the moment, though, possession is with Sydney FC, turned over now for the Wanderers. Chested down by Simpson. Turned over again by the Sky Blue. So what do the Wanderers take from this? Heather, you would have to think that they're going to be trouble in a couple of weeks when they've had a few more sessions to really gel together.
Yeah, I think they've had a really good pre-season. And I think there's some plenty of positive to take out of this game, especially the possession. But I think the problem today was Sydney FC are so confident in playing out from the back. There was no pressure on them, so they couldn't win it up front and couldn't transition quickly and hit anybody.
Well, Simpson's shift is over. Well done to the 17-year-old young Matilda, who we saw on debut here today. She is replaced by Gabe Marzano, who, as I said, is the only serving W League player, and quite fitting she should take some part here in this remembrance round. Well, Sydney FC, they certainly want to add another one to their tally before the full-time whistle. They've got about 90 seconds to do that. Sting completely gone now, and it looks like routine shuffle around the pitch in the Sky Blue shirts.
It's always a great rotation and players playing out of position and in other players' positions. It's great to see. That's why they're so effective. They know each other too well.
Kennedy calmly to Ralston. Ralston looks up. She spotted Bolger. Loose first touch. Sees it back with black and red. Carpenter recovered from her little knock and back on the park.
It was great to see and hear what Dan Barrett said, saying that he doesn't want to take the foot off the pedal about scoring goals. Sydney FC certainly had their chances to score a number of goals this half, same as the Wanderers, but it's exciting times. And
a stumble from Sham Karmas almost left the door wide open for Katie Stengel there. Stengel not quite quick enough to react.
I think she was almost stunned herself.
Yeah, not exactly what you expect. Sham Karmas has had a great day between the sticks. A clean sheet for the youngster. She's worn both colour shirts over the years, and it was her sister Lena who was scorer of the two goals. Now a chance for Georgie Yeomandale to perhaps add to that tally. Harmlessly in the hands of Jada Wyman, flings it up the pitch only as far as Nicola Bolger. And time ticking away, Kate Jakowitz takes a look at her watch.
Yeoman Dale's been fantastic down that right-hand side. Her runs, so aggressive. Just didn't quite cut that ball back. Really good to see the space she's getting herself into.
Yep, she's done well today, as have all the players in the sky blue shirts. A heroic effort from the Western Sydney Wanderers. Not enough, as Sydney FC take the ninth Sydney Derby. Two goals from Lena Karmas in the first half. Enough to seal the deal. Full-time here at Allianz Stadium. It finished Sydney FC 2, Western Sydney Wanderers 0.